the Arabs, they will stop using camels as a riding beast, and they will use something as a box. Is it to this, yeah? As a box that will carry them out from their houses to the mosque. But we know if the Arabs don't use camels as a riding beast, they have to use something else. And we know now if you go to Emirates, Qatar, Kuwait, Saudi, what do they use? Cars. And what Prophet Muhammad said? Something like a box. Yes, that's hadith. Which hadith mean what Prophet Muhammad mentioned. You see, because what you have to understand, Daniel, yeah? When God chose people to convey the message, what is our purpose of life? He did not just send them, just go check for your prophet of God. No, he had to give them something that differentiated them from the rest of the people. So as human beings, when we read what Prophet Muhammad said, then you come to the conclusion, no doubt this man must be prophet of God, because no one knows the future in detail except the Creator. Make sense? It's a logical argument. That's why, as a Muslim, without any doubt, we have proofs. First time I say, how come there's Christianity, there's Judaism? But we say, as a Muslims, Jesus himself never was a Christian. The term Christianity is not in the Bible, likewise Judaism. So we believe if I was alive at the time of Jesus, the only way to get to God is by following Jesus' teaching. Before Jesus was Moses, before Moses was Abraham, now the last prophet is Muhammad. So all of them came with the same foundations, which is what? Be grateful to your God, worship God for according to his way. Okay, for example now, if you want to buy a gift for your mother, would you buy a gift that you love or your mother love? Likewise, if you want to be grateful to God, the way he loves, not the way you love.
I'll have to look into it.
No problem. But does it make sense what I said so far?
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you can read.
It's not until you speak to people like you, you think maybe I should look into it.
That's it. Right. Because my family are reverts as well. You understand? They became Muslims.
It's what I do worry about. I worry that because I'm not a believer, maybe I'll be punished when I do die.
You got punished. Sorry, Daniel. You got punished. What do you mean you got punished? Sorry, say it again.
Because if there is a creator, when we die, if we meet him afterwards,
you'll be punished.
He's not going to respect me for not believing, is he?
That's a good point. That's
it's the only thing that I think negative about it. But then again.
But again, right, look, you have to understand, Daniel. Look, Islam is based upon justice. For example, imagine you never heard about Islam and you died. Allah mentioned the Quran, Allah will not punish anyone until the proof have been established against them. What does that mean? Like now we have a nice conversation with respect and everything. And you say, you know what, Islam makes sense to me. It's clear to me. But you know what, I'm too busy with life. Turn away from it. Then Allah mentioned the Quran, there's no one unjust more than the one who is reminded by Allah's verses and Allah's signs, and it turns away from it. That's the biggest crime. Because remember, all this creation and the miracle of the Quran. You see, for example, let me make it clear to you. One of the miracles of the Quran, that how come, if Muhammad made this book, how come there's 100 million of people memorize this book, word by word, letter by letter? Yeah, of course. You can check it on YouTube. It's 5 years old. Sometimes they don't even speak Arabic language, and they memorize the Quran word by word, letter by letter in Arabic. But then you guess what? It's been mentioned the Quran 1,400 years ago. Allah mentioned the Quran, the meaning of the verse. Allah said, the Quran will be easy for the people to memorize it. So this statement cannot be a statement of Prophet Muhammad. This statement must be the statement of someone who knows his creation. Who knows that this book, yes, the way it's been reviewed, people will be easy for them to memorize it. It's like, imagine Daniel, imagine you and I and the Prophet here, we memorize a book in Chinese language. But guess what? We don't even speak Chinese. That doesn't make any sense, either. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And one of the miracles is what is a miracle? Miracle is beyond human capacity and understanding.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? You go and guess the nature. So now, how this book, because there's many books, there's Bible, there's other books, how come the only book that has been preserved in the people's chest is the Quran? You see what I'm saying? Many people memorized it. So what you have to understand, Daniel, now, if Islam is clear to you and it makes sense to you, and you turn away from it, and you say, no, I'm too busy, then if you die, then don't blame no one except yourself. Because as I told you, if I give you £2 million, you said, you know what, I'll be very grateful to you. But I said, if I give you £2 million, give me your two eyes, what do you say? No, go. So you know your eyes is more valuable than £2 million. What about the one who gave it to you for free? You see what I'm saying? That's what is Islam based upon? Because it's true, there's some detailed information, but as long as the foundation is clear to you, Daniel, Then whatever comes after that, step by step. Where's the foundation? Foundation is that, look, I accept. I should be grateful to my creator, and I should worship him who has given me, according to his will, which is according to the prophet that he has chosen. And there's clear-cut proof that Prophet Muhammad is a true prophet, the fact that he prophesies about the future, and it's coming true. Understand? As for learning the prayers after that, step by step. I always mention this example, Daniel. If I give you, if you eat a cake, the whole cake at once, what will happen to you? You vomit.
Yeah.
You get sick.
Yeah.
In order for you to feel the sweetness of the cake, you take it bit by bit.
Mm.
Correct?
Mm.
That's what Islam. If the foundation is clear, it makes sense to you, then it's step by step. And what I will tell you, that you're not guaranteed to live tomorrow. If it's clear to you, and I'm inviting you to accept the truth, what is it? To say, I bear witness, there's no one worthy of worship except Allah and Muhammad, the messenger of Allah. Then you have a leaflet, you learn step by step. Even we have brothers here, they're from St. Albans here.
Yep.
You can meet up with, we have many English reverts here, understand? Meet up with. If it's clear to you, I'm inviting you to become Muslim.
Okay.
You want to become Muslim?
Well, I'll look into it, like I say.
No problem.
I'll definitely look into it.
No problem.
So you've got meetups nearby, it says in these leaflets.
Yeah, there's people around here. The brother, who is Abdurrahman? He's 18. But you know, even if you want to take my number, if you want to ask questions, because what you have to understand, Daniel, sometimes you're too busy with life.
Yeah.
Maybe you leave us now, I have to pay this, I have to pay that, then you forget. And what? They have come to you.
Definitely have a read, that's for sure.
Yeah, this one. Can you give me one? Was it the Islam?
This is a
compassion.
Very,
all right, Daniel.
Very nice talking to you.
It was nice
talking
to you, man.
Take care of yourself.
Our information is in the back. If you want to contact us.
This one here?
Yeah.
Okay.
So there's our email.
All right.
All right.
Cheers, buddy. All right. Take care.